William Morgan Jackson, black chemist, born 1936, still alive today as of October 2, 2022. William Morgan Jackson is a distinguished research and emeritus professor of chemistry at the University of California, Davis, and pioneer in the field of astrochemistry. His work considers cometary astrochemistry and the development of laser photochemistry to understand planetary atmospheres. He is a fellow of the American Association for the Advancement of Science and the American Physical Society and the American Chemical Society. In addition to contributing research work, he is notable as a mentor and advocate for increasing minority participation in science, where he was a founder of the National Organization for the Professional Advancement of Black Chemists and Black Chemical Engineers. In 2019, he was awarded the Astronomical Society of the Pacific Arthur B.C. Walker II Award for his research and commitment to promoting diversity. In 2021, he was awarded the American Physical Society Julius Edgar Lilienfeld Prize for outstanding contributions to fundamental chemical physics and spectroscopy associated with asteroids and comets, and for exemplary teaching at both the undergraduate and graduate levels, as well as lifelong service and inspiration to a diverse community. After completing 10th grade, Jackson joined Morehouse College as an early entrance student. He was awarded a full scholarship. At first, Jackson considered majoring in mathematics, but decided to study chemistry after meeting Henry Cecil McBay. He graduated in 1956 and applied to several graduate schools, including Northwestern University and Purdue University. He received a response from Northwestern, who said that they had already fulfilled their 3 fellowships for African-American students. Eventually, he moved to Washington, D.C., where he got a job and lived with his cousin. He studied at the Catholic University of America, where he was awarded a postgraduate research fellowship. During his doctoral studies, he worked at the Harry Diamond Laboratories, where he studied molten salt compounds. During the final year of his PhD, Jackson's wife became pregnant, and Jackson took time out of graduate school to earn money. During this time, he worked at the National Institute of Standards and Technology. He returned to the Catholic University of America, where he studied gasoline additives. After earning his PhD in 1961, he joined Lockheed Martin, where he worked on formaldehyde resins and ways to protect missiles as they re-enter Earth's atmosphere. He returned to the National Institute of Standards and Technology as a postdoctoral researcher, studying how radiant energy impacts chemical structures. He investigated how radiation impacts the coating applied to space vehicles. In 1964, Jackson joined the Goddard Space Flight Center. It was here that he became interested in the origins of free radicals in comets. While at the Goddard Space Flight Center, he proposed to use the International Ultraviolet Explorer satellite to look for comets. Using the Haystack Observatory, Jackson made measurements of water emission in comets. He joined the faculty at the University of Pittsburgh in 1969, where he spent a year researching and teaching. At the University of Pittsburgh, he worked with Wade Feit and Ted Brackman on the detection of electron impact on molecules using mass spectrometry. A year later, he joined Goddard, where he developed a system to detect free radicals using laser beams. In 1974, one of Jackson's colleagues, a professor of chemistry at Howard University, died suddenly. Jackson agreed to teach his course for the rest of the term and was subsequently appointed to a joint position in chemistry and physics. Here he began working on laser-induced fluorescence to study the Rho-V-Bronic coupling in cyanoradicals. He was the first person to demonstrate LIF could be used to study molecular photodissociation. He primarily studied comets using satellites, ground-based telescopes, using experimental data and theoretical predictions to establish how the free radicals inside comets form. Despite having left Goddard Space Flight Center, Jackson served as team leader for the International Ultraviolet Explorer Telescope, which observed Halley's Comet. He joined the University of California, Davis in 1985 and was promoted to Distinguished Professor in 1998. The Jackson Laboratory developed tunable lasers, which could be used to detect and characterize free radicals. These included excimer lasers, nitrogen-pumped lasers, and an alexandrite laser. By building laser systems in the laboratory, Jackson helped to establish the excited states of molecules that are present in planetary atmospheres. The experiments consisted of one laser for the photodissociation of the parent molecule and another laser to excite the free radical into an excited state. When the excited molecule fluoresced back to the ground state, the fluorescence was captured in a photomultiplier tube. He has investigated the photochemistry of carbon monoxide, nitrogen, and carbon dioxide. His laser systems exploit resonant four-wave mixing, which allows them to disassociate gases observed in planetary atmospheres. He also showed that it is possible to ionize the resulting atomic fragments using a velocity imaging time of flight mass spectrometer. In 1996, the Planetary Society named asteroid 1081 EE37 as Bill Jackson in his honor. He served as chair of the Department of Chemistry at the University of California, Davis in 2000. He retired in 2006, but has continued to research and recruit students. In 2013, he has made the Emil A. Dickinson Professor at the University of California, Davis. In 2019, the Journal of Physical Chemistry dedicated the special issue to Jackson. Citations are in the description.